Is there a particular reason why she brought the best mugs we've ever had brought to our set?
Beautifully shaped.
We will get there. No, they have a heft.
Fine
balance. They have a volume. There's a lot to them. We're going to get to all that. But, of course, the obligatory, do you want me to play the Lisa Simpson clip first or have you be Lisa Simpson? Just to get...
Well, I'll do Lisa Simpson because you can't really go anywhere and not do it.
Right.
So this
right.
is me. This is Lisa Simpson. It's really not that different. she's a great girl, though.
A great girl. Watch this.
I don't know how. I don't know when. But I super know why. I'll get revenge on you, Bart Simpson.
Will you be wearing my underpants when that happens?
Yeah.
And post.
All right, 30 years in, is the secret, not only you guys do these wonderful characterizations, that they don't age?
That is what I think the secret is.
Yeah.
It's sort of lightning in a bottle. It gives us, we remain the constant. It gives us this platform from which to comment on everything that's going on in the world. It's quite unique, and you, of course, you can't do that with live action.
Right.
And every time, Lisa Simpson is 8. Every time she has a birthday, she turns 8. And just
that's great.
And then this is something, and I've talked about this with Harry and so many others, the fans know more about it than you do.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I'm a great disappointment to our fans. They go, hey, remember the blah? I'm like, I don't. Tell me about that. Or they quote lines or, you know, what was it like meeting so-and-so? I'm like,
Oh, well. and then I tell you what, it facilitates an opportunity for you to do other things. And this is a big other thing. It's a podcast. Small Town Detectives is what we're calling it, about big crimes happening in small cities. I think we always, and look at this, 1.3 million downloads.
Wow.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Are you a fan of, like, I'm surprised, just in general, that crime is such a big thing.
I am too. I think for me, it was, I like the good guys to win. I sort of refer to it as my kindergarten view of the world, where sort of everything is quite linear. And now, looking back, I would say every crime is actually about a breach of trust. Mm. And trust is really the foundation of our society. When that starts to break down, the wheels come off the train. Mm. And so, like your parents, you trust them to take care of you and feed you and love you. And if they don't, then you have to do things that you never thought you would have to do. And when somebody breaks into your house, you trusted that they wouldn't do that. So. On our podcast, all of the cases are told by the detectives who actually investigated them. I co-host with my best friend, Zibby Allen, and we have two twin detectives, Detectives Dan and Dave. We change all the names. We don't give the locations. Mm-hmm. And we actually almost do none of the talking. Some podcasts are really free form. We're very sort of polished. Mm-hmm. And it's amazing. In less than a year, we have over 1 million downloads.
Wow, it's really extraordinary. And do you find there's commonality amongst the detectives? Like this thought would be, you know, a certain kind of person gets into this line of work.
Yes, I would say, they all say it's a calling, not a job. Mm. And the ones who are best at it are driven in the same way that anyone who has a passion for something, you know, actors, they always say, if you can do anything else in the world, do it because it's such an unkind business. I think law enforcement is the same. And one of the things, the other thing they say, which we love, is that they find telling these stories from soup to nuts, how the case came together. Because when we hear it on the news, you know, you really only get like a tiny tip of the iceberg.
Yeah.
So to hear the whole investigation actually turns out to be really cathartic for them. And our fans really, really love it. Can I say the name of the podcast?
Sure. Yeah.
So it's called Small Town Dicks. And if you don't think of dicks in terms of the Me Too movement, but rather in terms of the noir slang for detective,
yeah, exactly.
That's how we came up with the name.
And then very quickly, this is really interesting. You formed a production company.
I did.
Because you were tired of waiting for people to say
yes.
So
I don't get a lot of work on camera anymore. I don't know why, but part of it is doing Lisa Simpson. And part of it is I think they think because I have that great job, I don't want to work. It's ridiculous. So I was like, all right, I can't wait for you. So I will form my own production company with a terrific business partner named Ben Cornwell. And we develop projects across all mediums at the earliest stages because we want to be the people to be able to say yes first. Mm. And because of The Simpsons, we have a budget and we are able to do that.
Good for you.
It's really a gift.
A film the people have put together, you guys have put together, is called All Square with Michael Kelly. He's been here so many times, which is so good.
He's so brilliant.
He's such a good actor.
He's doing comedy in this film.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he plays a down-and-out bookie who starts betting on Little League games. Pamela Adlon plays his... not really love interest, because they kind of don't really like each other that much. but it opens in theaters on October 12th. It's really fantastic. And to see Michael do comedy is gold.
Oh, well, he's so good. All right. So as Yeardley told us, All Square opens in select theaters on demand October 12th. Small Town Detectives on iTunes. Mm. I know. It's embarrassing for me, too.
It's so dumb, Sam.
Yeah, okay, you say it.
What is it again?
Small Town Dicks is available everywhere you like to listen. iTunes, Stitcher, Spotify. Now we're on Spotify, Google Play. Go get it.
Simpsons season 30.
Wow.
On Sunday. Really nice to see you.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for the lovely mug.
These are great mugs. Yes,
you're welcome. Mug. And by the way, that's the mug you can't get anywhere else. It's the
special
podcast
edition.
You're guest on the mug.
Yeah. Only the guests get those mugs.
I can't show you the back, but
thanks,
you know what it says.